I done my share of bootlegging. Up there, if you engage in what the federal government calls illegal activity, but what we call just a man trying to make a living for his family selling a little moonshine liquor, it behooves oneself to keep his wits. Long story short, we hear a story too good to be true. It ain't.
It has been 11 months since we published our first deepfake tutorial, and today it is time to update this tutorial with the newest application, Rope Pearl. Rope Pearl has just been published today, and this application is many times better than our latest tutorial application. It is so much easier to use with so many new features, so let's begin the tutorial. You can follow the instructions on their GitHub repository to install it. However, I have prepared amazing installer files for you, so download the attachment from here. Go to the very bottom of the post. This post will be in the description of the video, so click here to download it. Then move it into your disk wherever you want to install. Let's install it inside Rope AI. So this is where I am going to install. Do not make its name as Rope. And then extract the files here like this. And this is it. We also have installer for massive compute. If you are using Linux, you can use it. So just double click the install.bat file. It will start installation. So for this installation to work, there are several things that you have to install yourself. Open a CMD and type Python like this. You should get 3.10.11. Preferably, you can also have 3.10.6, but I suggest you to use 3.10.11. What else you need? You need to also have installed Git. So when you type Git, you should get a message like this. You need to have installed FFmpeg. So when you type FFmpeg, you should get a message like this. You need to also have installed CUDA. So when you type nvcc --version, you should get a message like this. Unfortunately, there isn't easy way to test C++ tools, but installing all of these are step by step explained in this amazing tutorial video. So this is the tutorial video that you need to follow to install all those requirements. Once you have installed these requirements, you will be able to use pretty much all of the AI applications on your Windows computer. On massive compute, you don't need to install any of this. We are preparing the image for you. If you are using an Ubuntu Linux system on your local computer, you also need to install these yourself. So my automatic installer will also download all of the necessary modules into the accurate folders. You don't need to do anything else. Once you have installed these, you will just run my scripts, all of my scripts. I have so many scripts to install, and they will automatically install everything for you. Just patiently wait. Moreover, this script will generate a virtual environment. Therefore, this installation will not break or conflict with any other application you have on your computer. It will be totally isolated in the virtual environment folder. We can already see that. So when I enter inside the Rope folder, you will see that there is a VNV folder. So this is the virtual environment folder where everything is installed. The installation is also pretty lightweight. All of the modules are around 1.6 GB. There is also a virtual environment folder. So it shouldn't take too much space in total. We can see that in a moment. So it is around 6 GB. Moreover, I have prepared example images and a video file for you, so you will be able to directly test the application on these images and on example video file, which I am going to show. So the installation has been completed. I also fixed it. This system cannot find the path specified error, so you won't get it. So the Git folder also deleted. And now how we are going to start the application after the installation completed. Just double click the Windows start.bat file and it will start the application for you like this. This application has a nice GUI to use. Okay, so this is the application interface. It may be a little bit overwhelming at the first look, but it is fine. First of all, we will begin with selecting the videos folder. Since I have prepared example videos folder, I am going to select that folder like this and select folder. Once you selected the folder, it will scan all of the videos available under that folder. Then you need to select faces folder. So click the faces folder. I'm going to select the same folder because I have put everything inside, and all of the images of the faces will come here. What if you have just started the application or you added new files to the videos folder or selected faces folder how to refresh this interface. To refresh this interface, click this start Rope button here and it will refresh the folders and you will get the refreshed updated images in here. So after you click this start Rope button, it will repopulate the videos folder and also the images folder with the newest files. Then you need to select output folder. This is important. Click that and let's make a new folder here like outputs. You can save them anywhere and then select the folder and you will see the output folder is selected. Now, how does this work? This application is extremely advanced. First of all, select your video. Then as a next step, click find faces here. It will find all the faces inside that video. Then select the face that you want to replace. I'm going to replace first this face. Then select the face that you want to replace with him. When I click this face, it is done, but I am not seeing the replacement applied. So to apply the swap faces, you need to click here and you will see that in a moment face changes. The speed of updates depends on your computer and you see face changes. Let's also set a face for this one as well. For this face, I am going to use this and you see it is also changed. However, the quality is not great yet. So this application has a new way. When you select the swap resolution here, it will enhance it greatly. You see from 128 to 512. In our previous tutorial, it was only 128 pixel resolution. However, with the Rope Pearl, we are able to get 512. It is not native. It is done with mathematical tricks, but it is working. Are we done yet? No, there are so many options. I prefer to enable Restorer. This is going to apply face restoration. The best face restoration is GPEN 512. You see my interface frozen right now. This is the application only negative side. When you make changes, the application freezes until it is done. Then I will click this and it will apply that restoration. You need to wait to apply it. Yes, you see. Then I'm going to select original. I find this best. However, it is very strong right now. So I am going to make the blend ratio as 30% and hit enter and you will see that it will become much more natural and according to the flow of the video. Then I also make some other changes. Let me demonstrate you what I mean. So when you look here, you will notice that there are some mistakes. So therefore I am enabling strength and I am making the size border distance 20. One another thing is that when you hover your mouse over the settings configuration here, it will display you what does that configuration do in the very bottom of the screen. You will see the description of each option here. So as I move my mouse over each option, it shows me a very detailed description of what each option does. There is also support link of the original author of the Rope Pearl. So if you support him, it is up to you. Moreover, you can test them immediately. For example, let's make the strength 300 and it will apply the face much more stronger. You see it becomes like this. I find that 100 is working really decent. Then there is also occlusion that I find this is improving some of the errors. Pay attention to my mouse and see the error. You see, it is fixing that error. Actually, I have done some tests for you. When you enter tests and configs, you will have videos and the configurations in here. So you can look each one of them and see which differences each configuration makes to learn more. Then there is also Face Parser. This is also super important. Why? Now, let me demonstrate you. You see the mouth of the replaced face is very bad. We are going to fix that as well. Click here and make the mouth 10%. Okay. And now pay attention to the mouth and what it becomes. You will see that it gets fixed. Of course, this is preventing to use the target mouth of the image. However, this is fixing the mouth movement immediately. So this is super important. And there are other options. You can test them I didn't find them improving the quality. Based on your GPU, you can reduce the number of threads here to 1. So if you don't have a strong GPU, make the number of threads 1. Okay, we made everything, and now how we are going to do deepfake and face swap of our original video. So first of all, bring your scroll to the wherever you want to start replacing. I will replace the entire video, so I go to the beginning. You can also click here to go to the very beginning. And there is one more thing. You can set the output video quality from here. 18 is a decent quality. This is changing the video quality, nothing related to the deepfake or face swapping. Let's make this 12. 12 will get more size in the output video, but it will have a better quality of the video encoding. So this is related to the video encoding quality. You can also see the description in the bottom. Also, you will see that there is an option to support the original author, so it is up to you to support him. Okay, everything is set. So now how we are going to export final video? You need to first click this icon. It means that it is recording. Then you need to click play. So it will replace every frame and save it in a new video. You will notice that the frame is increasing in here. So since my thread count is 5, the frames processed increasing 5 by 5. So it is starting 5 threads and changing every frame with the new deep face swapping, and it is doing that 5 at a time. However, using 5 threads will use more VRAM. So let's see our VRAM usage. Currently, I am using 16 GB, but I already have been using like 6 GB before starting this video. So 5 threads is using about 10 GB GPU. So if you make it 1 thread, it should even work at 6 GB GPUs as well. However, don't you worry, because I'm going to also make a tutorial for massed compute. So if you don't have any powerful GPU, you will be able to use this application on massed compute. So where will be the output video saved? It will be saved inside output folder. When we go to the outputs folder where we did set, you will see that there is already a temporary video file. It is being generated. So we just need to wait. It is pretty fast. You see already 190 frames processed. While it is processing, I will also tell you some of the other options. You will notice that there is Retina Face, Yolo version 8, and SCRDF. So these are the AI models to detect the faces in the videos. If your face detection fails, then you can try Yolo version 8 or SCRDF. This will determine how well the face detection working. I strongly suggest you to install FFmpeg. Do not use OpenCV. FFmpeg works many times better, and it will work much more faster and smoother. Everything that you need to install step by step explain it in this video, so you will be able to run this application very well. This is not a pay wallet video, just watch it to learn it. The link of this video will be in the description of the video as well. And after that, you can follow the instructions on the official repository to install everything if you are not my Patreon subscriber. But I suggest you to become supporter of me, because it will make your life much more easier and pleasant. Okay, so the processing has been completed. You see we are at the 509 frame. Everything is done and our video is saved here. It's only 14 megabytes. Let's start the video and play it.
I done my share, boo. Up there, if you engage in what the federal government calls illegal activity, but what we call just a man trying to make a living for his family, selling a little moonshine liquor.
And it is working perfectly. Let me show you the properties. So this is a full HD video. You see 1920 to 1080, 24 FPS, 5000 kilobits per second. So this is super high quality. Currently, I am recording at 4K. Therefore, it may be looking small, but on the phones, on other platforms, on other machines, it will look perfect. This is a super high quality deepfake, face swapping. So what if you want to swap images, deepfake images, not videos? How to do that? To do that, click the image tab here. It will load the images in here that time from the selected videos folder. First, select your source image like this, then click find faces here, then select the found face, then select your target face like this, then enable swap faces here, After enabling the swap faces, make the swapper resolution to 512. It will improve. Then let's enable the restorer. Then let's select the GPE and 512, which is the best one, original. And this is it. This is swapped face. If you are not liking it, you can play with the other options, like in videos, like 200 power, like this. You can enable occluder. You can also enable face parser. Change the mouth or background. Let's, for example, try 10 mouth, and you will see that like that. So play with these options. To save your final image, click save image, and the saved image will be inside your outputs folder wherever you are saving, like this. There is also another option with the image changing, which is auto swap. So if you enable auto swap, it says that automatically applies your currently selected input face to the new images. And after that, I can change my source image and it will be automatically applied, as you are seeing right now. So this is how it works. Of course, it will not work very well with every image. Your image has to be compatible. Your face must be compatible. But you see, it is automatically applying. It is extremely convenient to use. From this option, you can find the best working face and change faces, then change faces in the video. So this is more faster, convenient way. Then click save and it will be saved inside the outputs folder. Then you can open the image, save it image like this. The best open source available right now. So there is no other better application than this. This works on desktop interface having systems right now. So you need to have either Windows or a desktop Linux system to make it work. But don't worry, I am preparing installers for Messed Compute. Currently our Messed Compute image is lacking few features. I messaged the others. So after our Messed Compute image is updated, I will record a video for the Messed Compute as well. For who doesn't have a GPU, it is only 31 cents per hour to use. So you will be able to use it perfectly on there as well. Our installer zip file already includes Messed Compute installation, so you can use this to install it on your local Linux machine, and Messed Compute will be ready hopefully very soon. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed. Please leave a comment, ask me any questions, and I should answer that as soon as possible. You see, you can scroll to any location and just wait a little bit and it will update the frame like this. So to be have more successful, you need to have faces that are compatible. If the face is more compatible, you will get a better result. And it is really, really good, as you are seeing right now. Thank you so much. Hopefully see you in another amazing tutorial.